wondering what would that be. So let me just now check if it is now fine. I hope I am connected to all of you. You can just check it once over there. Right, so
Yes.
yes, I am alive, but am I live on YouTube? That's what's my question. So I'm just so keen and excited to have the discussion of the entire subject of audit with you. So I hope that all the technical challenges have now been taken care of and we are all good to go. A very good morning to all of you and a warm welcome to the CA Final Advanced Auditing Assurance and Professional Ethics Batch. Right, my sincere apologies at the onset for the technical glitches which we had to face through in the beginning of the class. So probably I tried with a different encryption software this time. So our IT is always something which is goes out of control without any exception reasons or so. Right, so if you could just put a message for me on the chat box conveying to me that yes, you are connected and you are able to listen to me so that I can start with my interaction of the class with all of you and give you an outline regarding the new syllabus, the new material, and the flow and how we are going to go about our classes. Okay. Right, so please, if you could let me know if you are all connected and able to hear me. Even if a few of the students let me know, that's a good green signal, for me to yes, start my discussion over there. Okay. Right, so all good, everyone. Right, I hope, yes, I think you, in case if you've restarted the app or something like that, then in that case, you need to, switch off the app or the chat box and then start it again or like that. Okay, right, so the name of the subject is now Advanced Auditing Assurance and Professional Ethics, right? So earlier in the older syllabus, so it was Advanced Auditing and Professional Ethics. Now they have made the subject as Advanced Auditing Assurance and the Professional Ethics, right? I'm trying to give you an outline of the syllabus regarding the chapters and all, and then we proceed further with our discussion. Okay, right? Every day the class timings today I considered that we have been delayed for our class to begin with, but every day we start at sharp 9 o'clock. We have our first session up to 11:15, 9 to 11:15, then a 10 to 15 minutes break, and then after that we have the class from 11:30 to 1:30, right? So effectively around a 4 hour 15 minutes to 4 hour plus is what is how much of audit you are going to study every day, right? I want to give you one word of caution. When we begin with the class itself, that be careful. When you start reading the subject and when you start understanding the auditing standards and ethics and all, you start loving the subject of audit. So all your hatred, all your fear, all your phobia towards the subject of audit just vanishes, and the book looks so interesting, and you start feeling like studying the subject or so. ओके तो ऐसा भी हो सकता है कि शायद कोई स्टूडेंट्स यहाँ हैं जो जिन्हें हिंदी भी समझ आती है, तो मैं हिंदी में बोल सकती हूँ, मुझे बिल्कुल भी दिक्कत नहीं है. पर ऐसा है कि काफ़ी सारे स्टूडेंट्स जो है वो साउथ इंडिया से है, तो जिन्हें तमिल आती है और या तेलुगु आता है या कन्नड़ा या मलयालम, जो मुझे नहीं आता है, तो फिर ऐसा होता है कि उसके कारण फिर इंग्लिश एक ही मोड रह जाता है कम्युनिकेशन के लिए. राइट, सो दैट इज वाई लेटर ऑन आई हैव प्लान्स के ओके आई विल रिकॉर्ड माई क्लासेज इन हिंदी ऑल्सो. बट देखो, पेपर तो इंग्लिश में ही लिखना है ना, और जब कॉरपोरेट वर्ल्ड में जाओगे, मैकेंसी में जॉब करोगे, बार्कलेज में जॉब करोगे, या कोई क्रेडिट स्विस में जॉब करोगे, डिलॉइट, ईवाई, पीडब्ल्यूसी, केपीएमजी, ऐसे कंपनीज, बड़े बड़े फर्म्स में जाओगे, तो वहाँ इंग्लिश तो ठीक है, मतलब चाय पीते वक्त इंग्लिश में बात कर सकते हैं, बट रेस्ट तो वी हैव टू स्पीक इन इंग्लिश, राइट? We need to have a good command over the language. Anyways, that's your call. But yes, right now, this class mainly I will be teaching in English, all right, so that it is convenient and all the students are able to follow. कोई ऐसा जिनको हिंदी का प्रेफरेंस है वो ऐसे ज्यादा कुछ इसमें प्रॉब्लम नहीं आएगा. जैसे मैं बहुत बेसिक इंग्लिश जो स्टैंडर्ड्स में बताया गया है वो ही इंग्लिश बोलूंगी. मतलब ऐसे कोई शेक्सपियर या ऑक्सफोर्ड या ऐसा जो शशि थरूर जैसा इंग्लिश बोलते हैं वैसा तो मुझे आता भी नहीं है. तो आई नो दैट टाइप ऑफ इंग्लिश आई वॉन्ट बी सेइंग. सो इट्स गोइंग टू बी वेरी सिंपल, राइट? सो यू कैन जस्ट कीप दैट इन माइंड. सो आई होप यू आर ऑल कनेक्टेड एंड लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ आर discussion of our syllabus. So I'm so excited, you know, like it was like I was waiting for the preparation of the notes, and it's been like it's studying or preparing the new edition for audit was like equivalent to, you know, taking so many printouts and so many notes and culminating, and it's been really a very tedious process. Like just as how you prepare for the exams, I had to prepare for this new syllabus over there so that I could deliver the, yes, I'll try my best to deliver the best possible to all of you. Right, so let's begin with our discussion. Let me give you an outline of the syllabus regarding how many chapters are there and how do we go about the class. Okay, right, so as I already just mentioned to you, the name of our subject is now CA Final Advanced Auditing, and after that they have added the word assurance over there, right? So advanced auditing, because audit is not the only work that you do. There are a lot of other assurance services which are also provided, and then certainly we have our discussion on the professional ethics. Right, we have the discussion on the professional ethics. Right, probably you would be keen to see the cover page also of the book. Your books have already been dispatched, they are on the way, so they will be reaching to you shortly. So we have divided the book into two modules. So this is the module one. You see the name of the subject over there, Advanced Auditing Assurance and Professional Ethics. Right, the entire, this time I have decided that no black and white book or something colorful. There is a reason why I have opted for the colorful book. I'll be telling you the, you know, how the content of the book has been laid out and all. Right, so that's the module one, and then this is the module two. Right, so you have two modules over there because one book becomes a big fat book, so that, you know, the binding and all comes out. So, and psychologically also it's better to study from a small book over there, right? So like that we have the two modules over there, and in total we have the 19 chapters, right? So in my earlier courses, you know, I used to keep my chapters little different, and different in the context of as compared to what was there in the ICAI syllabus. Okay, content used to be the same, but little bit I used to, you know, jumble it up or put it as per the more, you know, in a different sequence over there. But now I thought, no, students have a lot of fascination and a comfort over there. If it is in line with the ICAI material in the same sequence of the chapters over there, and then also at the same time, we have the extra coverage in the book and better presentation in the book. Okay, and so we have 19 chapters, and out of the 19 chapters, chapter number 1 to chapter number 11 is regarding your standards. Right? So we have these standards. Can anybody guess कौन से स्टैंडर्ड्स है ये? किस चीज का स्टैंडर्ड बता रहे हैं वो यहाँ पे? अबाउट वॉट स्टैंडर्ड आर दे टॉकिंग अबाउट? यस, इंटर यू वुड हैव स्टडीड ना कुछ कुछ ऐसे 200 overall objectives of the independent auditor and the conduct of an audit in accordance with the standards on auditing, then SA 210 and all of that, right? So yes, you are absolutely right. We are not talking over here about the accounting standards or the international financial reporting standards or any such accounting standards over there. We are talking about the ऑडिटिंग स्टैंडर्ड्स. बट ऑडिटिंग स्टैंडर्ड्स में भी कैसा है पता है? यू हैव समथिंग कॉल्ड एज द एंगेजमेंट एंड क्वालिटी कंट्रोल स्टैंडर्ड्स, राइट? सो आई होप यू हैव टेकन आउट योर नोटबुक्स एंड यू हैव स्टार्टेड राइटिंग विद मी. टेक्स्ट बुक्स आर येट टू रीच टू यू, सो फॉर वन और टू डेज यू विल हैव टू मैनेज जस्ट विथ योर नोटबुक्स एंड द नोट्स दैट आई शो टू यू. बट नो प्रॉब्लम, वंस द बुक्स रीच टू यू वील मैचअप विद दैट. ओके, राइट? rather even I am waiting for a copy of the book, you know. So it's just printed and it's on the way. So waiting for the good services of DTDC to reach us. Okay, right. So engagement and quality control standards. That is what has been issued by the Auditing and Assurance Standard Board of the ICAI, right? The Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. I was just wondering okay, if India name become Bharat, then you know it will become Institute of Chartered Accountants of Bharat. So no, don't know okay, what is going to happen, but yeah, probabilities you never know. Right. So ICAI, the Auditing and Assurance Standard Board, has issued something called as the Engagement and Quality Control Standards. Right? Who is going to be performing these engagements? These engagements are to be performed by the chartered accountant, right? These engagements, these services are to be provided by the chartered accountants. Okay. Right. What type of engagements can a chartered accountant engage into, or what type of services they can provide? Here mainly they have mentioned the four types of engagement. Here mainly they have mentioned the four types of engagement. एक तो है ऑडिट, विच इज आर मेन ब्रेड एंड बटर. लाइक सीए क्या करता है, तो ऑडिट करता है. भले वो टैक्स ऑडिट रहे, इंटरनल ऑडिट रहे, स्टैट ऑडिट रहे, या एनवायरमेंट ऑडिट रहे, एनर्जी ऑडिट रहे, सीए बोला तो ऑडिट है ना, या टैक्स रिटर्न या समथिंग लाइक दैट. ओके, राइट. सो फर्स्ट वी हैव द ऑडिट, देन अदर टाइप ऑफ एंगेजमेंट इज द रिव्यू. Then we have assurance engagements, which are other than audit and review. So that's called as the other assurance. And then we have something called as the related services. Right? Then we have the related services, which is apart from an assurance engagement. Right. So for audit, as a CA, when you are doing an audit, you need to follow the SA, standards on auditing. When you are doing a review, you need to follow the SRE, the standards on review engagements. And engagements, so plural because there are two. But SRE, that is the standards on the review engagement. Then, when you are doing an assurance engagement other than audit or review, then you need to follow the SAE, that is the standards on the assurance engagement. And when you are providing certain related services, you need to follow the standards on related services. Right. So as a chartered accountant, there are four types of engagement that you can perform. You can either do an audit or a review or an assurance engagement, which is other than audit or review, or you could be providing some related services. And depending upon the type of engagement that you are performing, accordingly, you need to follow the particular standards. Like you have the standards on auditing, standards on review engagement, standards on assurance engagement, and the standards on the related services. And whatever be the type of engagement that you are performing, okay, whether you're doing an audit or a review or other assurance or a related service, whatever it be, you always have to maintain quality in the services of your firm. So we have a standard called as the SQC, that is Standard on Quality Control. Right? ICAI has also come up with the exposure draft of SQM, that is Standard on Quality Management 1 and Standard on Quality Management 2. Right? But right now, these are only the exposure draft. They are yet to be issued by ICAI. They are yet to be becoming applicable for your exam. So there is a change as compared to the existing SQC. So as of now, you study the SQC, but be aware, keep a track of it, that at a later point of time, this SQC is going to become an SQM, Standard on Quality Management, right? They talk about the quality management instead of quality control now. And SQC, we have only one SQC, one, right? But SQM, they have issued two over there, SQM1 and SQM two. Okay, right. So these are the five types of the standards. So engagement and quality control standards का पूरा variety क्या है? SA, SRE, SAE, SRS and the SQC. Okay, right. How many standards on auditing have been issued? 38 standards on auditing, two standards on the review engagement, three standards on the assurance engagement, and two standards on the related services. And as I already mentioned to you, just one standard for the quality control. Right. So this is the breakup of the 46 standards standards, right? This is the breakup of the 46 standards, which is applicable for your CA final exam. Right? In the old syllabus, only 36 standards used to be applicable. But now there are 10 standards which are applicable additionally to the new course. Right? Which are those 10 additional standards over there, which were not there for the old course, but there in the new course? So in the essay, it is essay 800, 805, and 810. What is it about? We'll study. We have a dedicated chapter number 8 wherein we discuss this. Right? Then we have SRS, Standard on Related Services, 4400 and 4410, for which we again have a separate chapter number 9. Right? We have a separate chapter for that. Then we have the SRE, Standards on Review Engagement, in which we have 2400 and 2410. Right, so review of interim financial information and review of, yes, a review of financial statements by the independent auditor and review of interim financial statement performed by the independent auditor, which is given in your chapter number 10. And then you have the SAE, that is the Standards on Assurance Engagement, 3400, 3402 and 3420, which is there in your chapter number 11. तो देखो मैंने तो क्या कर दिया है, चैप्टर नंबर 8 9 10 11 का आपको कंटेंट बता दिया कि 8 9 10 11 इज हैविंग दीस 10 एडिशनल स्टैंडर्ड्स. ओके, व्हाई आई एम वेरी 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 हैप्पी कि व्हाई व्हेन दीस स्टैंडर्ड्स हैव कम, बिकॉज अप टू मे 19 एग्जाम्स, अप टू मे 2019 एग्जाम्स, दीस स्टैंडर्ड्स यूज्ड टू बी एप्लीकेबल इन सीए फाइनल. तो मे 19 तक सीए फाइनल में देर यूज टू बी 46 स्टैंडर्ड्स विच वर एप्लीकेबल, देन दे चेंज्ड एंड देन दे रिमूव दीज 10 स्टैंडर्ड्स. तो आई तो यू नो गॉट सो डिसअपॉइंटेड दैट टाइम कि अरे ये कितना मजा आता था ये स्टैंडर्ड्स पढ़ाने में, एंड यू नो ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम यू गेन मास्टरी ओवर टीचिंग अ पर्टिकुलर स्टैंडर्ड एंड सो, एंड देन आई वाज लाइक ओ माई गॉड इट्स डिलीटेड, सो सो बट वट एवर, देन आई स्टॉप्ड, देन आई वॉज नॉट टीचिंग इट इन माई क्लास. But now when I saw them again, and then when I started referring to my old notes, it was like, you know, old memories coming back. Huh? Okay, this is what I used to teach, and this is the example and all, right? So already to some extent, I have a good understanding and mastery over these standards, right? Because I've already taught them previously. So that is one great addition to your syllabus. So, and now if you have heard in the new syllabus, 50 मार्क्स का वेटेज इज टू दी ऑडिटिंग स्टैंडर्ड्स. मतलब अब ऑडिटिंग स्टैंडर्ड्स की जय हो, एंड इट्स लाइक ऑडिटिंग स्टैंडर्ड्स आर गुड. ऑडिटिंग मीन्स engagement and quality control standards, all of them put together, are going to play a great role in your exams. Like earlier, the weightage for standards used to be like, you know, 20 to 25, maybe on the higher side 30, but abhi to ekdam 50 marks is standards, so very important. ठीक है, तो चैप्टर नंबर 1 to 11 इन योर बुक्स इज मॉड्यूल 1, एंड मॉड्यूल 1 इज हैविंग द डिस्कशन ऑन द standards. Is it clear to all of you? Standards hai, but in along with these standards, there is a lot of other discussion which is incorporated, like say audit program, internal control, and then audit strategy, right? So it's a culmination of the auditing standards and the theory which is done in the ICI study material, same which I have done in our books also. Right, so let me further give you a more detailed outline of the module 1. In module 1, to begin with, isme kuch bahut interesting hai, something called as chapter 0. Tum bolo ki ma'am ye kaun hai chapter 0? Like chapter 0 1, it has the list of the 46 standards which we have to study, and then second, it has all the important terms related to audit, you know, because you would have studied inter audit long time back, and then all of a sudden you need to refresh now, so kuch base, you know, you need to have something to start with. So this I added on my own. So I didn't want to change the sequence of ICI chapters. So then I thought, but I want to add something. So then I put it as chapter 0 over there. ठीक है, फिर चैप्टर नंबर 1 ऑनवर्ड्स टिल चैप्टर नंबर 11, एज आई टोल्ड यू इट इज दी स्टैंडर्ड्स विच वी आर डिस्कसिंग. 8, 9, 10, 11 चैप्टर नंबर तो आई टोल्ड यू स्पेसिफिकली कि उसमें क्या वॉट द डिस्कशन इज देयर ऑफ द 800, 2000, 3000, 4000 सीरीज ओवर देयर. एंड देन अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट आफ्टर 1 आई हैव पुट अ 1A. एंड 1A इज द मिसलेनियस स्टैंडर्ड्स, दैट इज द नेम आई हैव गिवन ओवर देयर. राइट, सो मिसलेनियस स्टैंडर्ड्स बिकॉज I saw in the CA final material they are not included, but you never know with ICAI regarding you know which question comes over there, right? So some few pages I had to add, but I think some 6 standards I have added additionally over there where no specific mention was there in the study material, but I wanted to make the book holistic, so I've included that. Okay, right, and then one more I want to mention is chapter 7A and 7B. Okay, 7B, very simple. It is regarding the CARO 2020 and the Section 143 of the Companies Act 2013. Section 143 क्या है? Duties of the company auditor, rights and duties. तो यहाँ पे इन्होंने सिर्फ duties, बाकी 139, 140, 142, 143, and all that is like not applicable for your exams. So from company audit only CARO and section 143 which is there in 7B, and in chapter 7A you have the entire 700 series. You might have heard, no, SA 700, 701, 705, 706, 710 and the 720. So that is there in the 7A, 7B. So what has been done? One, there is a chapter 0 which gives you the basic terms. Then after 1, there is 1A which has the miscellaneous standards, and 7 has been divided under 7A and 7B. Alright, so I'm very excited to bring the you know module 1 in front of you after giving you a briefing regarding it. Right, so I've mentioned here that it's module 1 and the module 2. And then this is the chapter 0 and then 1, 1A, 2, 3, right? And if you check this, this is exactly matching with the contents or the syllabus which has been given by ICAI, right? So it is same, but there is obviously a lot of addition and question bank and editing also being done over there. Okay, right, so that's your which chapter covers which standards, that has also been mentioned over there. Like I just told you about the 700 series, right? It is having these standards, and the second part is regarding duties of company auditor and CARO. Theek hai, fir chapter 8, 9, 8 is the 800 series, 9 is the related services, 10 is the review, and 11 is the 3000 series over there, right? So that is your module 1. Okay, if you look into the new material of ICAI, what they have done, almost in every chapter they have put 3 varieties of question over there. Ek to dala hai, one to what they have put is called as the test your understanding. Listen to me, either udhar nahi, no distraction, and focus only RT ma'am, only audit is what you need to focus on. Theek hai, to in the syllabus, in the study material of ICAI, they have put something called as the test your understanding. Then kuch ek ek in some chapters they put 2 or 3, but generally like one integrated case scenario, which is like a cakewalk, you know, after you study the chapter and you see it, it's very easy to solve those 4 or 5 MCQs given at the integrated case scenario. And then you have something called as test your knowledge, which is nothing but your theory questions which you've always been studying. Right, so MCQs and test your knowledge is your theory questions which always have been there, but test your understanding is more of the practical application part, okay, wherein they actually, the questions are a little tricky. Okay, as they now a real life situation has been given, and then how do you apply and how do you check it in the, so if you practice this well, no, that will prepare you to solve the case studies in the exam well. Right, so in our books also, if you check at the end of every chapter, like if I take you to chapter, or this is 0 as I mentioned to you, right, and then after the chapter 0 we have the chapter 1 which is quality control, and in this you see the entire SQC 1 and SA 220 in this chapter, right? So SQC 1 SA 220 is there in this chapter, and after this chapter ka theory gets over. I'll come back to it again, don't worry. I just want to show you the last three parts. So see, this is test your understanding, wherein you have the case scenario based question. The question and the answer is given over there. Then after that, you have the integrated case scenario. So there's a beautiful situation given, and then you have the questions, you know, the MCQs and even the answers have been put over there. And then you have your test your knowledge. Okay, so test your knowledge. ICAI study material has like few questions, but अभी एसए चैप्टर वन इस एसक्यूसी वन एंड एसए 220. सो फार दिस वाज देयर इन द ओल्ड सिलेबस आल्सो. सो फार व्हाट एवर क्वेश्चंस हैव कम रिगार्डिंग एसक्यूसी वन एसए 220 इन द एमटीपी आरटीपी सजेस्टेड यू नो ऑल द रेफरेंस मटेरियल ऑल केस स्टडीज ऑफ आईसीएआर ऑल ऑफ दोज क्वेश्चंस हैव पुट ओवर हियर. Right? So it's not only the study material ka test your knowledge which is over here. There is lot of additional questions which have also been added along with the answers, and where it's a direct question, it also gives a reference, you know, regarding whatever point you need to refer to. Right, so you see a huge, you know, question bank over there. So if you check it with the study material of ICAI chapter 1, mein kitna questions hai wahan pe, and if you see it over here, how many questions are there, you'll be able to notice it on your own. Like if I open it over here, this is chapter 1 as per the study material of the, right, so I'm talking a lot about the study material because certainly that's your Bible, you know, that's your Gita, Quran, or your, you know, main content from where you're going to study the subject now. Okay, so test your knowledge, like you see over here, there's 5 questions there, you know, in test your knowledge. And if you check in our book, how much knowledge of yours I'm testing over there? Oh my God, you know, ma'am will check your knowledge so much, 16 questions. Right, so you get it, how I have incorporated it over there. And then other, okay, I told you, now I've decided no black and white, only color book, because I have done a lot of red markings in the book. Like one day before the exam, revise karna hai, so you know, you have to study the entire subject and all. So I've done the marking of the important words for you over there. Right, so in black and white, this red marking won't come out. Right, so I read it line by line, identified, and then, you know, put all the markings over there. So my analysis of the book, like had I been a student at your place, my analysis of the book would be that one, it is entirely in line with the ISM, that is the Institute Study Material. Study material has 19 chapters. This also has 19 chapters. Then in addition to that, if I want to use the book as a scanner, कि क्या क्या क्वेश्चन आए हैं, कैसा अलग से स्कैनर का मोटा बुक लेने से अच्छा, दिस बुक ऑल्सो सर्व द पर्पज ऑफ योर स्कैनर, बिकॉज ऑल क्वेश्चन यू नो लाइक एथिक्स, तो यू विल फॉल डाउन और ड्रॉप डाउन लुकिंग एट द नंबर ऑफ क्वेश्चन फॉर द क्लॉजेज ओवर देयर. राइट, सो यू नो वट एवर ICAI क्वेश्चन आर अवेलेबल टिल डेट हैव ऑल बीन इनकॉर्पोरेटेड. सो it's an inbuilt scanner into the book, so someday if you want to use the book as a scanner also, it is possible for you. And then you also can use it as a, what do you say, a compact or a crispy notes or highlight notes or something like that. So like if you read only the headings and the red words, to ho gaya. और अगर लगा कि नहीं इतना सा पढ़ के एग्जाम में आई वॉन्ट बी एबल टू राइट द आंसर, आई शुड रीड द एंटायर सेंटेंस, तो रीड द एंटायर सेंटेंस. एंड सो द यू नो इट्स एन ऑल इंक्लूसिव पैकेज विच आई हैव ट्राइड टू पुट इट ओवर देयर. राइट, सो ऑल द इम्पॉर्टेंट टर्म्स इन ऑल द चैप्टर्स, नॉट ओनली इन चैप्टर वन अप टू चैप्टर नंबर 19, यू नो द एंटायर थिंग आई हैव पुट इट इन दैट पर्टिकुलर मैनर. Right, obviously students have a lot of concern regarding the number of pages of the book. Right, so module 1 is having the 455 pages, right, and module 2, the M2, is having the 385 pages. Right, so 450, if I'm not wrong, it is, yes, 455 and 385 pages, right? So somewhere around 840 or something, like pages coming up over there. So 840 pages may, like 800 plus pages also, you can take it that way. Okay, 800 is, 400 is the theory part and 400 is the question bank part. So effectively, matlab, if you want to study only theory, if you don't study the test your understanding and integrated case scenario and test your knowledge, toh phir 400 pages hi hai. Aur woh sara padh liya, toh aur 400 pages hai. Toh aisa hai. Hai na, toh bahut, too many books and too much. No, itna padh lo, more than enough. And सुन लो, है ना, लिसन टू वॉट एवर आई स्पी टू यू इन द क्लास, दैट शुड बी मोर देन इनफ. अरे हो ना तुम सब लोग वहां, यू ऑल आर देयर राइट? हाउ डू आई कम टू नो यार दैट यू ऑल गाइज आर ओवर देयर? यस, ऑल ऑफ यू देयर लिसनिंग? यस, ट्राई. अरे पढ़ना है तुम्हें इस बुक से, सो यू हैव टू गेट एन आइडिया रिगार्डिंग यू नो वॉट ऑल इज देयर इन द बुक एंड ऑल ऑफ दैट. यस, सो आई होप यू हैव गॉट अ ब्रीफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग एंड यू वुड बी लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू रिसीव द बुक ऑल्सो. कि वंस यू गेट द बुक्स देन यू कैन स्टार्ट विथ योर मार्किंग्स एंड ऑल ऑफ दैट ओवर देयर. यस, सो पुणे आई एम नॉट टीचिंग फेस टू फेस. दिस क्लास इज कंडक्टेड लाइक देर इज ओनली अ कंप्यूटर इन फ्रंट ऑफ मी. देर आर नो स्टूडेंट्स इन फ्रंट ऑफ मी. सो द स्टूडेंट हैज आस्क्ड मेनी टाइम्स आर यू टीचिंग फेस टू फेस इन पुणे ऑल्सो. सो नहीं, पुणे माझं माहेर आहे, पण यू नो आई एम जस्ट टेकिंग इट फ्रॉम माय होम इन दिल्ली राइट नाउ. एंड आई विल बी टेकिंग माय क्लासेस लाइक आई हैव पुट अप माय सेटअप एट टू प्लेसेस, एट माय होम एंड एट माय आई हैव परचेस्ड एन लाइक टेकन एन ऑफिस प्लेस ऑल्सो. सो एट ईदर ऑफ द टू प्लेसेस वेर एवर पॉसिबल आई हैव आई वुड बी टेकिंग द क्लासेस राइट. सो इट्स नॉट एनी लाइव क्लास एनी वेयर विच आई एम टेकिंग. आई हैव बीन ट्रैवलिंग एक्सटेंसिवली टू टेल यू ऑन अ पर्सनल नोट, बट नाउ आई हैव डिसाइडेड कि प्रोबेबली आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू टेक दी क्लासेज फ्रॉम होम. सो यू ऑल्सो बी इन द कम्फर्ट्स ऑफ योर होम लाइब्रेरी स्टडी रूम और वट एवर एंड आई बी ऑलवेज देयर फॉर यू राइट इन योर कंप्यूटर और योर मोबाइल, है ना. तो ऑल ऑफ यू लिसनिंग राइट, एनीबडी एनी क्वेश्चंस, एनीथिंग विच यू वॉन्ट टू आस्क टू मी राइट? सो आई सी सम ऑफ द नेम्स ऑफ माई अर्लियर स्टूडेंट्स, विच इज ऑलवेज अ प्लेजर यू नो टू सी दोज नेम्स ओवर देयर राइट. माई सिंसियर अपॉलॉजीज वंस अगेन फॉर द टेक्निकल ग्लिच विच वी हैड एट द बिगनिंग. आई एम वेरी लाइक वेरी वेरी सॉरी फॉर द ट्रबल कॉज्ड टू ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर दैट. यस, तो नाउ फास्ट ट्रैक एंड मैराथन एंड ऑल ऑफ दैट, लाइक यू नो फर्स्ट लाइक फर्स्ट हर्डल और फर्स्ट चैलेंज वॉज लाइक प्रिपेयरिंग द बुक. सो नाउ द फर्स्ट एडिशन इज रिलीज, नाउ नेक्स्ट वन इज टेकिंग द रेगुलर क्लास, देन वन बाय वन वी गो फर्दर विद इट राइट. सो एनीबडी आई एम लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू रीड सम ऑफ योर मैसेजेस इन द चैट बॉक्स इन केस इफ यू गाइज वॉन्ट टू मैंशन एनीथिंग. द फ्लो ऑफ द क्लास, येस अर्जुन, श्योरली आई एल बी मैंशनिंग. तो पहले थोड़ा मटीरियल के बारे में आई मैंशनड एंड नाउ आई एल बी ऑल्सो टेलिंग यू अबाउट द फ्लो ऑफ द क्लास टूडे. वो ही टूडे इज इंट्रोडक्शन नो. सो आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू गिव यू अ ग्रिप और आउटलाइन ऑफ आर डिस्कशन इन द क्लास. यस, समबडी एल्स आस्किंग, आवाज वगैरह ठीक है, वो आंसर दे देते हैं स्टूडेंट्स. इफ आई आस्क देम इज द ऑडियो ओके, सो एटलीस्ट दैट मच दे रिप्लाई, यस मैम वी आर एबल टू हियर यू एंड सो. यस, नाइस, ओके राइट. दोज ऑफ यू ऑन द एनक्रिप्टेड वंस आई होप, ओ या दैट्स नाइस, बुक नॉट रिसीव्ड आ जाएगा, डोंट वारी. वो मैंने बोला ना अभी, आई हैव ऑल्सो नॉट रिसीव द बुक्स, इवन आई एम वेटिंग, इट्स लाइक वेटिंग फॉर डी टी डी सी सर्विसेज टू बी क्विक राइट. सो यूल रिसीव इट, नो वरीज अबाउट दैट. बट रेस्ट हैज इट बीन ओके फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू, वॉट एवर आई टोल्ड यू अबाउट द मॉड्यूल वन? येस, आई टेल यू अबाउट द मॉड्यूल टू, देन आई टेल यू अबाउट द आउटलाइन ऑफ आर क्लास एंड देन एवरी डे आर टाइमिंग इज गोइंग टू बी 9 to 11:15 एंड देन 11:30 to 1:30. सो दैट्स गोइंग टू बी 4 hour प्लस ऑफ क्लास एवरी डे. सो एटलीस्ट 40 days इज मिनिमम वॉट आई हैव प्लान्ड. संडेज लेट्स सी, आई विल कीप इट नॉट मेंशन एनीथिंग राइट नाउ, बट या मोस्टली संडेज वील नॉट हैव अ क्लास. But that's how. Keep a notebook in front of you. You need to keep some stationery in front of you. Like in terms of stationery, I want basically for you to have your notebook, like a 200 pages dedicated notebook to begin with. Wo bhar gaya, wo fill ho gaya, so then one more book you'll have to purchase. Then I want you to buy soap. One is notebook. Then after that, I want you to get some color pens. You know, red, green, blue, yellow, orange, pink, purple. Or lavender, जो भी वट एवर कलर पेन्स यू गेट यू नो सो दैट यू कैन डू दी राइटिंग एंड मेक द चार्ट्स वेन आई मेक दम इन द क्लास एंड देन मे बी वन और टू हाईलाइटर्स नॉट मच बट या मे बी यू कैन गेट सम यू नो नियॉन कलर विच डोंट गेट फेडेड दोज टाइप ऑफ हाईलाइटर्स एंड देन यू कैन ऑल्सो गेट इन सम स्टिकी नोट्स राइट दिस इज ऑल वॉलंटरी दिस इज माई सजेशन टू यू सो दैट इफ यू फाइंड सम निमोनिक आई हैव गिवन ओवर देयर सम इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन या amendment so you can just put a post-it or a you know page and a stapler something like that you can sticky note wherein it remains with you and now ye whatever book you get or whatever notebook you have to enlighten it you have to bring it to life you understand no audit like it because you'll just listen to the subject you'll forget you understand you remember but you have to remember recall the concepts So for that you have to give life, you know, to your book. Like you have to literally, like you know, infuse the life energy into the book. Like you know, you should be very familiar. Okay, what markings have you done? What have you been writing? What is the type of question which could come? What is the example given over there? So that you do. I keep writing with me when I'm teaching in the class. I keep on using these the journal notes where I write. So I don't say that, ma'am, we want a copy or something. Nahi, I want you to write on your own because I also write every time. So you also write. Agar nahi hua, to anyways, that is recorded class. So take a you know photograph of the chart or something that I've prepared. Later on, copy it down. You know, so do ensure that. Okay. Right. So this is regarding the stationery or the writing part of the class. Then apart from that, please, unless and until I am not taking the class, you always have to be present. Right? I won't be absent unless if required. Like rare that I am absent also. But yes, you always have to be present whenever I am present. Right? Make a very conscious. Effort and you know arrangement in a manner that you are able to uninterruptedly like in terms of what you say 5G 6G 7G 5G available hai, but jo bhi hai matlab whatever data pack is required or whatever silence is required you know make those arrangements which are required for you to dedicatedly attend the class and come what may right whether all the prime ministers come to our country or whether some wars happen or whatever happens you make it a point that 9 to 1:30 you attend the class every day right no excuses at all just make it a discipline just take it as a goal for yourself like what are 100 days every day 100 push-ups like that of next 40 days or 50 days or whatever days every day or 4 hours of audit so that type of a discipline don't pamper yourself are nahi aaj nahi are nahi tomorrow are I'll see the backup kuch nahi no matlab backup will be given to you but nahi You know, keep your laptop charged in case if the power goes. Keep the backup ready. You know, keep whatever like you know, and a sitting posture. Don't you know, be very luxurious when you are attending the class or so. And so maintain discipline. Just to be you know 6 months or 8 months, and then you are a professional and a chartered accountant. So little bit of patience required. ठीक है सो बी डिसिप्लिन्ड डोंट यूज योर फोन अदर देन फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ द क्लास डोंट कीप मी ऑन लाइक अ बैकग्राउंड म्यूजिक और अ सारे गामा कारवा कि मैम अपनी बज रही है पीछे और यू आर बिजी टॉकिंग टू कि खाने में क्या है एंड व्हाट टॉकिंग टू समबडी एल्स और समथिंग ऐसा नहीं करना है ना तो थोड़ा डिसिप्लिन का ध्यान रखोगे तो क्लास का ज़्यादा बेनिफिट होगा इफ यू टेक केयर ऑफ डिसिप्लिन यू विल गेट मोर बेनिफिट फ्रॉम द क्लास ओके राइट सो एनीवेज नाउ आई हैव टोल्ड यू अबाउट ओनली अबाउट द मॉड्यूल 1 नाउ आई नीड टू टेल यू अबाउट द मॉड्यूल 2 राइट सो आई होप इट्स क्लियर टू एवरी वन दैट इन मॉड्यूल 1 वी हैव द स्टैंडर्ड एंड इन दैट वी हैव चैप्टर नंबर 0 to 11 राइट मॉड्यूल 2 इज हैविंग द चैप्टर नंबर 12 to 19 Right, 12 to 19. Chapter number 12 is a brand new chapter in your syllabus, which is called as the Digital Auditing and Assurance. Right, a mind-blowing chapter over there, wherein they have talked about the next generation audit, and then talked about the machine learning, and then the cyber attack and the cyber risks and all of that. Right, so a great chapter in line with the developments, like they've talked about artificial intelligence, blockchain, and robotic process automation, and you know. augmented reality, virtual reality, right? So like a great understanding of the entire cyber, like how do you do the audit in the IT environment, right? So we have a brand new chapter over there, which is the digital auditing and assurance. Then we have chapter number 13, which is called as the group audits, right? So in the old syllabus, this chapter used to be called as the audit of the CFS. Does anybody know what is CFS? Any guess? CFS? Very easy question, no? Ma'am is asking. Right? Audit of? Yeah, you're absolutely right. Consolidated financial statements. Right? So now that chapter content is same to same, but only name has been changed from CFS to group audit. Right? So only the name has changed from CFS to group audit. Okay. Right. Then you have a chapter number 14, which again in institute study material, it is as one chapter, like special features of audit of banks and NBFCs, but I have divided it under 14A and 14B. 14A is regarding the audit of the banks, and 14B is regarding the audit of the non-banks. Non-banks means non-banking financial companies, right? So NBFCs, that is the audit of the NBFC, right? So this CFS, that is group audit and bank and NBFC, these were there in the old syllabus, and the same thing is carried forward into your new syllabus also, right? Then after that, we have a chapter number 15, which is an overview of the audit of the public sector undertakings, right? So public sector undertakings, again, the chapter was there in the earlier one, and same carried forward over here, right? Then you have a chapter number 16, which is internal audit, right? So only internal audit. If you see in the old syllabus, like along with internal audit, there used to be something called as the management audit and the operational audit also. And just in case, if you see some old RTP suggested, then you might see these questions, so you know that it's not applicable, right? So this management operational audit ko gaya, to usme abhi sirf internal audit, right? And that only we have a dedicated chapter on the internal audit. Then we have chapter number 17, which is regarding the due diligence, right? The investigations and the forensic accounting, right? Due diligence, investigation, and the forensic accounting. Earlier, they used to call this a forensic audit. Then everywhere they replace the word audit with accounting. Right, so you have the forensic accounting. By the way, in chapter number 16, which is the internal audit, they've also given a brief understanding of the SIA, that is the standards on internal audit. And in forensic accounting, they've given a briefing of FAIS, that is the forensic accounting and investigation standards. Right, so they've given the titles and all of that over there. Right, so due diligence as it is. इन्वेस्टिगेशन में थोड़ा चेंज है एज कंपेयर टू दी ओल्ड वन. रादर जो कंपनीज एक्ट का पार्ट था इन्वेस्टिगेशन का, दैट दे से स्टडी इट इन योर सेल्फ पेस्ड लर्निंग मॉड्यूल. एंड फॉरेंसिक अकाउंटिंग, दैट इज अ रीवैम्प इन द कंटेंट. It was there in the old syllabus, but a little bit of plus minus over there, right? So that's your chapter number 17. Then you have chapter number 18, which is the ESG and SDG assurance. Anybody, would you like to guess? ये कौन है? ESG एंड SDG? लेट मी सी योर जनरल नॉलेज, लेट मी सी हाउ अपडेटेड यू आर रिगार्डिंग व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इन द रियल वर्ल्ड, राइट? एनी गेसेस रिगार्डिंग व्हाट इज ESG एंड SDG? कैन यू प्रोवाइड द, ओके, सो नो द एनक्रिप्टेड बुक, आई विल पुट इट ऑन द सॉफ्टवेयर, सो फ्रॉम दैट यू कैन एक्सेस इट, राइट? सो दैट शुड टेक केयर ऑफ इट. ठीक है. यस, एनीबडी, एनी गेस क्या है ESG SDG? कुछ तो होगा ना, इट माइट बी समथिंग. नो, यस, एनवायरमेंट, सोशल गवर्नेंस. यू आर गिविंग ऑल आंसर्स राइट, हम, वेरी गुड, राइट? ESG, दैट इज द एनवायरमेंट, सोशल एंड गवर्नेंस. एंड SDG इज द सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट गोल्स. The sustainable development goals, right? So ICAI has again issued the SAS. Matlab, can you believe it? They have issued something called as the SAS, SAS, social audit standards. Right? So lately I have taken a printout of the social audit standards and I'm reading those. You know, there's something called a social stock exchange. Well, the Bombay Stock Exchange, National Stock Exchange, so hey, but pata hai, social stock exchange bhi hai abhi. So, because you have to be, socially responsible also, right? So CSR तो था ही, but this is again a brand new chapter in your syllabus. तो दो ना एकदम खटाखट नए आए हैं, डिजिटल ऑडिटिंग एंड अश्योरेंस एंड देन दी ESG SDG एंड दोस 10 स्टैंडर्ड्स, दे हैव कम बैक, है ना? दे वर देयर अप टू मे 19 एंड नाउ दे हैव अ कम बैक इनटू द सिलेबस. यस, एनीबॉडी एनी गेसेस के लास्ट चैप्टर कौन सा होगा? अभी मैंने तो तुम्हें सारे चैप्टर्स बता दिए. 1 to 11 इज स्टैंडर्ड्स, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 बता दिया. 19 गेस कर लो, 19 गेस इट. टाइप नो समथिंग. यस, यस. व्हाट वुड बी, एनी गेस, वाइल्ड गेस? यस, वेरी गुड आंसर. डू यू रिमेम्बर द नेम ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट? सब्जेक्ट का नाम याद है तो फिर गेस कर सकते हो, है ना? आई शोड यू नो द कवर पेज ऑफ द बुक. वेर इज इट? है ना, एडवांस्ड ऑडिटिंग अश्योरेंस एंड व्हाट्स रिटन ओवर देयर, राइट? व्हाट्स रिटन ओवर देयर? सम आई थिंक मिसलेनियस टॉपिक्स. अरे 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 रेड्डी जी, अगर मिसलेनियस टॉपिक्स पढ़ेंगे तो फिर एथिक्स कहाँ पढ़ेंगे फिर हम लोग, है ना? तो जो लास्ट चैप्टर है, जो बहुत ही बड़ा चैप्टर है, विच इज रिगार्डिंग दी प्रोफेशनल एथिक्स एंड दी लाइबिलिटीज ऑफ दी ऑडिटर. ओ माई गॉड. सो टूडे यू, एटलीस्ट ऑल ऑफ यू लिसनिंग टू मी ऑन यूट्यूब एंड लिसनिंग टू मी थ्रू द लाइव क्लासेज ओवर देयर, नो दैट ओके वॉट आर दी चैप्टर्स विच आर देयर इन सी ए फाइनल ऑडिट. एंड नॉलेज इज पावर. जब भी अपने को पता रहता है ना तो हम लोग इसे एकदम पावरफुल हो जाते हैं. वी लाइक बिकम पावरफुल ओवर देयर, राइट? सो प्रोफेशनल एथिक्स एंड दी लाइबिलिटीज ऑफ दी ऑडिटर, ओके, राइट? सो एनीवेज, देयर आर अ लॉट ऑफ चैप्टर्स व्हिच आर नाउ नॉट देयर, लाइक ऑडिट कमिटी, कॉर्पोरेट गवर्नेंस, कंपनी ऑडिट, ऑडिट ऑफ इंश्योरेंस कंपनी, पीयर रिव्यू, क्वालिटी रिव्यू. सो यू विल से एनीवेज मैम नहीं है तो फिर हमें क्यों बता रहे हो? तो इसीलिए आई एम नॉट मेंशनिंग, आई एम नॉट राइटिंग अबाउट देम. यू कैन सी माई वीडियो ऑन यूट्यूब ऑल्सो के वॉट इज द चेंज इन द ओल्ड एंड न्यू सिलेबस. सो दोज ऑफ यू आर इंटरेस्टेड विल कम टू नो थ्रू दैट, ठीक है? तो दिस इज द आउटलाइन ऑफ द चैप्टर्स, राइट? सो दीज आर दी 19 चैप्टर्स. इफ यू चेक इट इन द स्टडी मटीरियल ऑफ ICAI ऑल्सो, वी हैव दीज 19 चैप्टर्स ओवर देयर. ओके, नाउ कमिंग टू हाउ वी गो अबाउट आर क्लास, राइट? सो टू गो अबाउट आर क्लास, आई विल स्टार्ट विथ द, एनी गेस टू बिगिन विथ? वी विल स्टार्ट विथ द, यस, द लास्ट चैप्टर फर्स्ट. दैट इज वी डू आर यू नो बिगनिंग इनिशिएशन ऑफ आर स्टडी ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट विद द चैप्टर ऑफ द प्रोफेशनल एथिक्स एंड द लाइबिलिटीज ऑफ द ऑडिटर, राइट? देन आफ्टर दैट इनेविटेबली वी विल हैव टू गो टू द चैप्टर नंबर 7, which is regarding the audit report, क्योंकि you have to know the report, right? Before you come to know about anything else, right? So no, no, chapter 0. I'll start with professional ethics. Chapter 0, तो जैसे the terms will come, I'll keep on telling you, you know, regarding whatever are the terms and so. Okay, right. So chapter number 7, which is regarding our what you say the 700 series ka auditing standards. Coincidence, na? Ki 700, chapter 7 mein 700 series, right? So 700 series, and which also has our CARO and also has our section 143. Right, and then once we do our SA 700 and so, then we come to the other standards and the other chapters. So we see how it works, like we do the chapters and standards mixed and that particular manner. Right, so that's the outline. Ethics would probably take a week, a very, very important part of your syllabus, because you know in CA final audit paper, like 12 to 15 marks is the weightage of ethics. Like, you know, in the theory part of the paper, you see at least three questions of 4-4 marks each. Sometimes it could be of 5 marks also. But minimum, like, you know, we new syllabus ka, to we'll get to see the pattern when the MTP and all comes. But as of now, what we understand is 12 marks is the weightage of the ethics in the theory part, right? You know, your paper is divided into two parts, right? 30 marks is for the MCQ and 70 marks of your paper is for the theory part, right? In the 30 marks of the MCQ, they have the integrated case scenarios, and those integrated case scenario, two integrated case scenarios where they ask you five questions, and then 10 general MCQs are over there, right? So you have some 20 questions, like 10 questions are two marks and 10 questions are one mark each, and then you have the 70 marks of the theory, right? So ye jo 70 marks theory hai, in that 12 marks comes of ethics, and then you know in the MCQ part of the paper also you can see like 2-3 marks of ethics over there, right? So that's 12 to 15 right marks. Sometimes it goes up to 20 also on the higher side. This is stock market na, lower circuit and upper circuit. Like sometimes it can go to 20 also, some rare attempts it comes down to 10 also, but woi, on an average if you get to see it, it is in the range of 12 to 15 marks. Okay, right. So just look at it. No, like if you study the, what do you say, standards, the entire standards over there, that institute has clearly said that now 50 marks weightage to the auditing standards, and then you do the ethics, which is like, say, let me take it as 15 marks, right? So this itself covers the 65 marks of your paper. Right, that itself covers the right 65 marks of your paper. But anyways, never have a thought in your mind regarding doing the selective study. One, because of the MCQ. From any nook and corner of the books, they ask the MCQ. That's one reason. You know, so because of the MCQ, we cannot have an option of leaving anything an option. That is one reason. And the second is because of the AB format of the paper, the ABC format. Like, you know, you have question number three, ABC, question number four. I'm just giving example, ABC. Okay, a question number three, A is say on bank audit, right? Say B is on the digital auditing and assurance. And say C is regarding the ethics. Example. And say here also you have a question regarding SA 700. Then you have a question regarding say the ESG, SDG. So SA 700, or say maybe you have a question on the PSUs, and then you have a question on the CARO. Right, what happens, no, when you do selective preparations or you want to study a few chapters and not study a few chapters or few questions or something like that, the problem is ki if you want to write this ethics ka answer, array, so for this bank audit and digital auditing assurance answer also you'll have to write. Right, so keeping this in mind, you have ample amount of time with you. You have good, you know, plan your studies in a very effective way right away. You understand that you want to cover, don't push, don't rush, or don't keep anything for the last moment over there. Okay, right. So that's the outline of the class. So we'll be starting with the module two first. Module two may be your last chapter hai, which is the professional ethics and the liabilities of the auditor, right? So if you check it in the study material of ICAI, the chapter is going like into 172 pages there, right? So you know, institute in the beginning of the chapters has also given some, you know, what do you say, some overview of the chapter, trying to create a real life situation over there, right? So later on you can read these also, because it just creates the situation ke why ethics is important. Like that's the new thing they've done before every chapter, and very high tech English, huh? They have used that some words are like very like people who've made the book are really having good English over there. That's what I can say. Right, so exhaustive code of ethics is in place that not only contains, so they create a case scenario type. And then if you check in our study material also, we have a big discussion on the ethics, a huge chapter over there, right? So that's the chapter number 19, right? So it starts from page number 251, and then at the you know, it's like last few pages are the notes, so those pages we may not count, but yeah, apart from that, it goes from 251 page number to 318, right? So So that's a huge chapter over there. Again, I told you the reason why it is huge is because of the amount of the questions which are there. Like in ethics, we have something called as the clauses, and then you see this integrated case scenario. So ye sara dal ke, matlab, that's the reason why the the chapter size is big, and ethics has always been a big content in your books. Okay, right. So, how does the first look of the book look to all of you? Like, I am so excited, to reveal and start teaching, and I try to make a lot of updates. So, as you study more from the book, I'm sure you guys will be able to give me more of your genuine feedback regarding the book and tell me how things can go better and so. But yes, I've tried to make it a little more appealable to all the students, right? So शुरू करें, all of you, right? Professional ethics and liabilities of the auditor. So they are basically an old syllabus. We had a chapter called as liabilities of auditor under company law. वो तो हट गया, बस उसका नाम रह गया. But here they are talking about the liabilities of the auditor under the Chartered Accountants Act 1949. Correct? Yes, all good. ऐसे एकदम ओके होके आर यू सिटिंग नाउ? यस, नोटबुक है सामने. हाउ मच हैव यू रिटन इन योर नोटबुक सो फार? नथिंग. नॉट रिटन योर नेम ऑल्सो? कुछ नहीं लिखा. ओके, यस, एनी थॉट्स इन योर माइंड? एनी क्वेश्चंस दैट यू वुड लाइक टू आस्क? फिजिकल लॉस. फिजिकल लॉस तो गया, अब नहीं एप्लीकेबल है न्यू कोर्स में. टैक्स ऑडिट, इट्स गॉन टू जी डीटी सिलेबस. सो आई एम ग्लैड दैट यू गाइज नो, के व्हाट इज हैपनिंग. यस, जस्ट मार्किंग स्कीम्स वन पेज. ओ, यू हैव रिटन वन पेज. आ, नाइस नाइस. राइट, ऑल ऑफ यू फ्रॉम डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ द कंट्री, या all becoming chartered accountants and great people over there. It's very nice. Yes, two pages you've written. Great. YouTube, yes, I'm waiting for all of you to come onto the encrypted classes. Any holidays for festivals, ma'am? So let's see when the festival comes that time. Right, so if festival comes and we give holiday, then we'll have to compensate on Sunday, na? तो वैसा करना पड़ेगा फिर. Okay, the backup of the classes will be available on daily basis. Yeah, so see, right now when I'm taking the class, I've put it for recording. Unless and until recording में no error happens, I can upload it like after compressing the file, I can upload it by the end of the day. But sometimes some things might go wrong. So in that case, then whatever is streamed, we need to download that and then process it. Or sometimes there's the two lectures which needs to be patched or something. So 1 or 2 days here or there. But generally, by the end of the day, it should be up and live. But why you're asking? I know you're going to attend entirely live only. I know you've committed to yourself, so no worries about it. Yes. Yes, YouTube students, have you gone on Magnet CA? So Magnet CA is another portal where you can see all the various faculties for all the different subjects, from where you can purchase your books and videos, and also aartilaoti.com is there since quite some time, the website. So any of these two websites, you can go and right, make your decision if you need to join the classes, and then yes, we have our discussion of the subject of audit. Yes, so it's nice, now it will be a routine for you. Okay, 9 o'clock class is starting, so accordingly you plan your day, and then things get very organized and disciplined once you are you might be already having na some experience. Koi kiya hoga, or is this your first live class? Everybody, FR, SFM, done, done, are done, done. Yes. DT, IDT. Just ensure, okay, if you are writing your exams in May, by Jan मिड जैन और मे बी बाय एंड ऑफ जैन मैक्सिमम सब क्लासेस आर डन, सो दैट फेब मार्च अप्रैल एग्जॉस्टिवली यू विल बी एबल टू गिव योर टाइम फॉर योर स्टडीज. तो उस वक्त फिर ये क्लासेस का वगैरह नहीं चाहिए. अभी 14 आवर्स, 16 आवर्स, 10 आवर्स, 12 आवर पेन ड्राइव, PD, GD, फेस टू फेस जो करना है कर लो, बट मेक इट अ पॉइंट दैट डन एंड डस्टेड यू नो, सो दैट वेन यू स्टडी फ्रॉम 1 फेब्रुवरी ओनली यू एंड योर मटीरियल. और इन केस इफ योर अटेम्प्ट इज इन नवम्बर, बाई July or something, just plan to finish your classes. Like I remember when I had to write my CA final, so in 2008, right? So I became chartered accountant. I wrote my exams in November 2008, and Jan 2009 the results came, right? So that's when I became a chartered accountant. So 2009, and it's been quite some time then, right? And I was like a feather or like an additional, like it was like bonus for me that I also got an All India rank 24, right? Always my plan or my study was like I want to clear the exams, but yes, I worked hard and somehow very disciplined, and I got a rank over there, right? So foundation I cleared in 2005, and then inter, that time it was P1 P2, entered in 2006, and then after that for 3 years I did my articleship in Deloitte, during which I got a lot of experience regarding going to listed companies and getting an exposure to the corporate world and all of that. And Deloitte and these big fours over there, they have an audit software, just as the companies have the accounting software. These companies, they have the audit software, and whenever you do an audit, your audit documentation and all has to be done as per those files or the working papers which are there in the software, right? So that has always helped me to give a better delivery to the students of the auditing standards, right? Or for all chapters, because I've seen it happening in a big four, for listed company quarters and all. Like I have so many quarters, like June, September, December, March, June, September, December, March. You do the same thing again and again, and so you see the same documents and all. So that's why I have an interlinking or a practical insight into, the auditing standards, and that's why it's one of my very close to the heart type of an area for me. And over a period of time, obviously everything relating to the subject is my passion. So teaching is my passion. So since I finished my articleship in July 2009, that's 31st July 2009, and already in January 2009 I had cleared my exam. So since September 2009 I started teaching, right? So it's been years now, decade plus, 1.5 decade or something. So it's just whatever knowledge I have of my subject, I want to pass it all to all of you, and want you to, have the confidence for the preparation of the exams, write the exams very well, get amazing marks, get an All India rank, and do best in your life, right? So that's the purpose, that's my well, the book Ikigai, it says you should have a purpose in life. Having a purpose in life is very important. Just say your purpose in life right now is to become a chartered accountant. So now I'm on the other side, already become. So ab kya, ab tumhe chartered accountant banana, ye mera purpose hai. So that's how it is. First life class, to kaise lag raha hai first life class? Good na? Am I too away from you? Thousands of kilometers away from you? No, I am right in your study cabin, just in front of you. I'm just like a few inches or half a meter away from you. Not at all very far, right? So if I come on full screen, so then so I am more there. Right. Create one group on WhatsApp or Telegram for any doubts or queries. Okay, so I'll do that, and I'll put my, what do you say, team member manager also on the group, and in case if there is any technical queries, they can solve it, and if any other subject related query, they can pass it on to me and I will get it solved. जो हुकुम आका है ना, तो ऐसा करते हैं, ठीक है? मस्त, ऑल गुड, लेट्स स्टार्ट. Any time, anything regarding the speed, or you're not able to follow a topic or a concept or any genuine concern or anything negative also you want to tell or whatever it is, it should, you're giving me your time, which is very, very precious. So I don't want that anything wrong or ना कुछ गलत हो जाए. सो जस्ट लेट मी नो वॉट एवर चेंजेस और अमेंडमेंट्स आई कैन डू एट माई एंड, हाउ मच एवर कम्फर्टेबल एंड गुड आई कैन मेक इट फॉर यू. आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू लीव एनी स्टोन अनटर्नड. आई वॉन्ट ईच एंड एवरी स्टूडेंट टू बी सेटिस्फाइड आफ्टर अटेंडिंग दिस क्लास. तो वो मेरी इच्छा है. तो वो इच्छा पूरी करने के लिए तुम लोगों को मुझे सपोर्ट करना पड़ेगा, ऐसा है ना. Where to buy these books from? Please start giving PDF so that students can get idea on coverage, presentation, change with time. Huh? So I am a change with time. Yeah, yeah. So I'm coming, waiting for the PDF of the hard copy of the book to be received by me. Then I will be discussing the book contents. I'll be making a video on that regarding how the book contents are there. So yes, thank you so much for the genuine suggestion over there, right? So that would be taken care of, Thana. And you can buy the books, as I said, from aartilauti.com or magnetca.com. magnetca.com, I really like their tagline. It says CA in you, ki tumhare andar ek CA hai, bas usko you know institute se stamp laga ke lena hai, chartered accountant hai na, aise karne ka. इतना हिंदी चलेगा ना, इफ आई स्पीक दिस मच हिंदी. माई साउथ इंडिया स्टूडेंट्स लाइक यू नो लाइक एनीबडी हु डजंट नो हिंदी, लाइक नॉर्थ ईस्ट वेस्ट साउथ मिडिल इंडिया एवरीबडी, ऑल आर माइन ओनली स्टूडेंट्स. बट या लाइक आई हैव बीन ट्रैवलिंग टू चेन्नई एंड केरला एंड यू नो सो मच, सो इट्स वेरी मच अ पर्सनल कनेक्ट विच आई फील टूवर्ड्स द स्टूडेंट. और गुज्जू माड़ू तो मैं खुद ही माड़ू मारवाड़ी हूँ, तो उनके साथ तो हमेशा ही कनेक्शन बनता है ना, और ऑल यू नो फुल ऑल इंडिया कनेक्शन. ठीक है, सो लेट्स कम बैक. जनरली स्टूडेंट्स से दैट मैम डजंट डिस्कस एनीथिंग अपार्ट फ्रॉम द क्लास, सो दैट्स व्हाई आई थॉट लेट मी टेल समथिंग अबाउट मी एंड मेक यू कंफर्टेबल विद द क्लास, बिकॉज वंस आई गेट इन टू द यू नो डिस्कशन ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट देन नथिंग एल्स टू बी डिस्कस्ड ओवर देयर. यस, you're from Andhra Pradesh. Achha, right? So Andhra Pradesh, there I learned few words over there like kucho and then cheppo and then you know those words which after being over there for like it's such a technical language, I don't know, I couldn't like Hindi, Marathi, Gujarati, Marwadi, they look all similar, but you know Tamil, Telugu to nahi, matlab it's just so difficult to follow. It looks like encrypted language for us. It's a Java plus type. So that's how it's been. But yeah, I've had wonderful memories of Hyderabad also now, which is in Telangana. ठीक है, आंध्र प्रदेश गुंटूर. I recently finished a marathon batch in Guntur also, so which is again masterminds, one of the best academy for CA coaching. You know the atmosphere and the environment over there, like mind blowing. So I have been associated with them also. So aisa hai. Theek hai. Good morning. Now some student is wishing me. Oh, good morning. Theek hai. Right. So let's start with our discussion on the yes. Oh, Delhi. So you know, someday you can you know. We can have a discussion if you in a personal doubt solving session for those students who are from Delhi or NCR area, right? So that we can meet at some place and have a discussion or something like that, hai na? So because even I am in Delhi, hai na? So aisa kar sakte hai. Theek hai. I'm watching from Hyderabad. Aap Hyderabad mein the bahut time. I used to have taken so many classes in Hyderabad. Okay. Right. So, but now I'm going to take class from home, and tomorrow, probably one of the days, I'll be taking the class from my new office also. So I'll show you the setup over there also. Hello. So, like, let's start now. I'm very good. How are you? Students are asking. मैं एकदम मस्त हूँ. है ना, तुम भी मस्त रहो एकदम. है ना, इतना हिंदी चलेगा ना, कोई जो other parts of like those who don't follow Hindi, इतना okay okay ना. Okay. Right. So. Let us begin with our discussion on the ethics, right? So Chartered Accountants Act, right? When you create a company, you need to get yourself registered under the Companies Act. You are governed by the Companies Act 2013, right? So when you create a company, when you form a company, you are governed by the Companies Act. Similarly, once you become a chartered accountant, you are governed by the provision of चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स एक्ट 1949, राइट, द चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स एक्ट 1949, राइट, द सीए एक्ट 1949, राइट. सो द चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स एक्ट, सो वंस यू आर अ चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट यू आर बाउंड बाय द प्रोविजंस ऑफ द चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स एक्ट, राइट. व्हाई चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स एक्ट, लाइक व्हाई डू यू नीड एन एक्ट फॉर अ चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट, बिकॉज यू आर टेकिंग अ मॉरल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी. द स्टेक होल्डर्स, द शेयर होल्डर्स, द क्रेडिटर्स, द इन्वेस्टर्स, द गवर्नमेंट आर रिलाइंग ऑन योर वर्ड्स. व्हेन सीए सेज ट्रू एंड फेयर, इट्स ट्रस्टेड. सीए ने बोल दिया ना, बस बात खत्म, है ना. सीए सेड ट्रू एंड फेयर, फिनिश. फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स वुड बी गुड. सो दिस ट्रस्ट, दिस कॉन्फिडेंस, दिस रेप्यूटेशन व्हिच इज देयर ऑफ द सीए इज बिकॉज दे नो कि द चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट इज रेगुलेटेड बाय द प्रोविजंस ऑफ द चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स एक्ट 1949, एंड इन केस इफ ही डज एनीथिंग रॉन्ग, हिज मेंबरशिप कुड बी कैंसल्ड बाय ICAI और अ COP. ही कुड बी टोल्ड टू सरेंडर अ COP, दैट इज अ सर्टिफिकेट ऑफ प्रैक्टिस बाय द ICAI. बट एवरी प्रोफेशन हैज इट्स एथिक्स. Every profession, let it be doctor, let it be an engineer, like a doctor when he is doing a surgery, like say he is doing some surgery in the stomach or so. So when he is doing the surgery, he cannot forget any needle or knife or, you know, some instruments inside the stomach. Like later on they do the sonography and then they come to know, aray, ye seedha to andar hi reh gaya. So that's not right. Or you give the wrong prescription of medicines to the patient, or you give the wrong treatment. Ethically not right. You know, you have to, they take the vow, no, the doctors, that we will take, put in our best, you know, to save the life of the patients and so. Right? So just as the doctors are regulated by their respective ethics, similarly for the chartered accountant also, we have the Code of Ethics, which have been issued by the ICAI. And Code of Ethics 2020, right? They keep on revising the Code of Ethics time and again. Right. So one, you have something called as ethics. Ethics matlab kya? Moral value. Ki cheating nahi karne ka, jhoot nahi bolne ka, not to cheat anybody, not to say anything false, not to do wrong work, do your work properly. This is ethics, na. This is, you know, they say, no, okay, somebody robs 500 rupees from your wallet, you say, what ethics you have, yaar? Kya ethics hai ya nahi? Or, you know, you one friend told you some information, told you, don't tell anyone. No, the moment it is told, don't tell anyone, then you become restless and you want to tell it to 10 people. So then you tell it. So ethically, galat hai. Ethically, like, you know, you are making an your Ola bill was 400 rupees, but from office you claimed 800 rupees. Galat hai. This is not ethically right. Is it right? So ethics, and your we ek to ethics hota hai, which are there for a human being. So every chartered accountant is a human being, and apart from the, what do you say, human being, he is a, being a human being, he is a chartered accountant. So that is why not only ethics, what he has to also follow is the professional ethics, right? The CA, what he needs to follow is the professional ethics. Okay, professional, and you are a professional, so what are the professional ethics for a chartered accountant, right? So now if I give you an outline of this chapter, right, we are starting our discussion on chapter number 19. We are starting with the last chapter first, which has a weightage of 12 to 15 marks in your exams, right? So this chapter, I'll give you an outline of this chapter. Okay, what all we discuss in this chapter, and then we begin with, right? So professional ethics, and I don't know why they added this liabilities of auditors, uska naam bada kar diya, but theek hai, no problem. And liabilities of the auditors, okay, right? So now professional ethics, one, we are going to take an overview of the code of ethics. Right, so what are the parts in the code of ethics and all of that. Then I told you, obviously, we are discussing the provisions of the CA Act, CA Chartered Accountants Act 1949. So obviously, in an act, there is always going to be these sections of the act, and then there are the schedules to the act. Like, you know, Companies Act, you have the Schedule 3. Which gives you the format and so, right? You have the schedules to the company law. Similarly, you have the schedules to the Chartered Accountants Act. Right. So, schedules to the Chartered Accountants Act. Basically, there are two schedules. You have the first schedule to the Chartered Accountants Act, and you have the second schedule to the Chartered Accountants Act. Right. Our main discussion, like our 80 5% of the discussion is going to be regarding these two schedules to the Chartered Accountants Act, the first schedule and the second schedule, where the 34 clauses, you know, of ethics have been given. What are these clauses and all of that? I'll come to it. And where the 34 clauses of ethics, okay, when chartered accountant, you know, CA will be guilty. Guilty matlab apradhi, you know, galat kiya, matlab guilty galat. That he has done something wrong and he has done some wrong behavior. His behavior was not proper. So he could either be guilty of the, they are talking about two types of misconduct, professional misconduct or the other misconduct. So other misconduct is also covered under the Chartered Accountants Act. What comes under other misconduct? I'll come to that. Right? So guilty of professional misconduct or the other misconduct. So generally when a case study comes in your exam, then you have to write down the clause over there and in the given case, and then write down at the end of the answer the conclusion. Ki yes, ye guilty hai ya nahi hai? Ki whether this chartered accountant is guilty of professional misconduct or whether this chartered accountant is not guilty of the professional misconduct, right? So, or other misconduct, whatever it be. Right? So, that's the part regarding the schedule. And then before that, we have the sections. So, sections, we don't discuss like all the 80, 90 sections of the Chartered Accountants Act. We just discuss a few sections of the Chartered Accountants Act. Like, you know, section 4, entry of name in the register. Okay, when is your name entered into the register of ICAI. Section 8, when you cannot become a member of ICAI, disabilities for membership. Then section 7, members to be known as chartered accountants, right? Then you also have the disciplinary mechanism. Section 27, which is regarding maintenance of branch offices. Section 25, companies not to engage in accountancy. And then section 24, penalty for falsely claiming to be a member. So, one by one, like few sections of the Chartered Accountants Act we have to discuss. One important one is section 2.2, members who are deemed to be in practice. And so sometimes we also see a question coming in the exam from these sections. Right, so one or two questions, like sometimes they also come from the section, or one question from the section and two, three from the clauses or something like that. And so we need to discuss the few sections of the Chartered Accountants Act and the 34 clauses given under the two schedules to the Chartered Accountants Act. And before that, we have an overview. And in this overview, okay, why ethics? And why there is ethics in order to ensure the compliance with the fundamental principles, right? The fundamental principles. And fundamental principles can also be called as the एथिकल रिक्वायरमेंट के अगर तुम सीए हो तो तुम्हारी क्या एथिकल रिक्वायरमेंट है, व्हाट ऑल आर द एथिकल रिक्वायरमेंट फॉर अ चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट, राइट? एंड ऑब्वियसली एथिकल रिक्वायरमेंट ऑलवेज इन एडिशन टू इट हैज द रिक्वायरमेंट रिगार्डिंग द इंडिपेंडेंस, राइट? सो रादर व्हेन यू सी द टाइटल ऑफ एन ऑडिट रिपोर्ट, व्हाट डज द टाइटल ऑफ द ऑडिट रिपोर्ट से दैट इट इज एन, यस, व्हाट डज द टाइटल ऑफ एन ऑडिट रिपोर्ट से दैट इट इज एन, yes, what is the title of the report? Audit report ka title kya hota hai? Yes, it is the independent auditor's report, right? So even the title of the audit report, you're not just saying it's an audit report, you're saying that it's an independent auditor's report, right? So we have a huge discussion in the chapter of ethics regarding the independence of the auditor. Right, we have the discussion regarding the independence of the auditor. Yes, independent audit report. Amazing. Right, so one, we discuss the fundamental principles, which are also called as the ethical requirements. In addition to that, we also discuss the requirement of the independence. Maybe you might have heard it, or we'll discuss it again, that as a chartered accountant, you need to have not only the independence of the mind, but you also need to have the independence of the appearance, right? Not only the independence of the mind, but also the independence of the appearance is required, right? Then in ethics, there is a new concept called as no clar. And again, just in May 23, it was the first time that they asked a question on no clar in the exam. And so no clar stands for the non-compliance, and NOC is the non-compliance with the L and R, that is the laws and regulations, right? Non-compliance with the laws and regulations. Okay, now chartered accountants, when in service or in practice, we'll see the applicability of NOCLAR. When you are working in a company or when you're doing an audit of a company and you come to know some non-compliance with the laws regulation, you have to bring it to the attention of the management and also to the attention of the appropriate authority, that is the regulators and so. Right, so that's the new discussion which is there in ethics regarding the NOCLAR, and then you have some council general guidelines. Right, towards the end of the chapter, we have some discussion regarding the council general guidelines. Right, so mota mota, more or less, I have told you all that we are going to discuss in the chapter of the ethics. Right, so overview, sections, the two schedules to the Chartered Accountants Act, the first schedule, second schedule, in which you have the 34 clauses, and then to begin with, it will be the fundamental principles, which are also called as the ethical requirement, including independence, then a discussion regarding the NOCLAR, which is the non-compliance with the laws and regulation, and we also have certain council guidelines, which we need to counsel, the Council of ICAI. Right, we also have the council guidelines to be seen. Right, so if you see the ICAI website, right, you have the council of the ICAI over here, right, you have the council, right, so whenever we talk about council, this is the council of ICAI that we are talking about, right, so the Southern Council, Regional Council and all of that, right, so these are all the council members over there, right, so Western Region and all of that. Okay, so the council of ICAI, right, these are elected by the members, right, so every 3 years the ICAI elections take place, and then from these council members they make the various committees, right, the standing and the non-standing committees. Like I told you, the auditing standards, they are issued by the Auditing and Assurance Standard Board, right. Then ICAI has also constituted a Digital Accounting and Assurance Board, right, so this Digital Accounting and Assurance Board is giving a lot of information regarding the blockchain and all of that, right. So concept paper on embracing robotic process automation, right, then concept paper on blockchain technology, then the ABCD of technology automation, and you know, I told you there's something called as FAIS, Forensic Accounting and Investigation Standards, right? So this is, then there is also an ICAI certification course on forensic accounting and fraud detection, which is a post-qualification course which can be done. Right, so these are the like the different committees of the ICAI, right? So many committees. Then sustainability reporting, right? We talked about a chapter, na, ESG and SDG. And so ESG was what? The environment, social and the governance. And then SDG is the sustainable development goals, right? So for that, the ICAI has constituted the sustainability reporting standard board, right? And these are the different publications. And again, you can do the certificate course for BRSR, right? That is the business responsibility and the sustainability reporting over there. Okay, right, so you have the different publications. I think I mentioned to you about the social audit standards, right? I told you, like, just as you have audit standards, there's something issued by ICAI also called as the social audit standards, right? So do take out some time, you know, to go through this wonderful website of ICAI and see the different, like, see the sustainable development goals. Right, so all the different content, and we will also go through it at the respective places in our class, right, whenever the point comes, at that time we go through the same. Okay, right, so with that, let's begin. So everybody, have you got an outline of the chapter? Is it clear regarding what all is going to be discussed? It's the it's the biggest chapter, not one of the, it is the biggest chapter. So probably a week's time we take to complete this chapter, or something less than that, and 5 days at least. And then once we are done with the chapter, we come to the audit report, which is again very interesting. Theek hai everyone, all good? So do you know the logo of ICAI, or the ICAI emblem, you know, the logo which is there of ICAI, under that there is written, no, your Esha Supteshu Jagarti, and your Esha Supteshu Jagarti, and there is an eagle which is there in the What do you say in the logo of ICAI, right? So it says like how an eagle is very vigilant and very cautious and it can catch the prey. Similarly, you have to be very vigilant and catch out all the frauds and errors which are happening in the financial statements. And nowadays, anyways, becoming a auditor is not a easy job. You know, it is just cannot be taken for granted, or you know what, I just have to sign a report saying true and fair. Aisa nahi hai. You know, NFRA, it is making your life tedious, miserable over there. The National Financial Reporting Authority, the amount of cases, the amount of orders which have been passed against the chartered accountant is just increasing day by day. Right, so you have to give a lot of importance to audit hygiene, and you can't take it for granted. हाँ किया होगा, ऐसे कर लिया, वैसे कर लिया, नहीं चलेगा. And 700 audits you do properly, one audit you don't do properly, and you are in trouble. And you are in trouble in terms of your reputation. Monetary loss, ठीक है. Emotional loss, what do you say? Reputation loss, all that is there. But main, you know, it's your income stops because and the reputation is gone. Right? And it's such a bad patch over there. So you have to be very careful. Your client should never like you. If your client starts liking you, that means they are very comfortable. That means they can, you know, sugar-coated words and they can convince you with whatever. They should always be scared of you. They should always be, oh my God, okay, auditor. Yes, so थोड़ा उनको कंट्रोल में रखने का. You should not be in the control of the client. That's very important. You have to make them, you know, you have to make the client uncomfortable. Uncomfortable asking them, nee, this provision, no, but I'm not understanding why you took this entry. No, I'm thinking I'll take an opinion of a lawyer. I thought let me discuss it with the other senior partners of my firm. So when you create that type of an environment, even they are more particular. Even they are getting an assurance regarding the quality of work being done by chartered accountant. Then any, you know, any bad play, any foul play done by anybody, it comes out. But if you are very lenient, like you know what happened in case of Satyam, अरे 7,000 crore of fraud, like 5,000 crore of bogus cash was shown in their books. Why? Because auditor accepted photocopies of FD receipt, photocopy accept कर लिया. So it's not done intentionally, but it is intentionally. You don't want to do it wrong, but just because of the casual approach, okay. Nothing happens, you know what happens, nothing will happen. So it's that risk-taking attitude which becomes the you know problem over there, right? So that when we are okay, client will go to another auditor. No. So all of you be strong, all chartered accountants everywhere be strong. So they come to know, oh my God, I thought this CA would be better than that CA. They say, you all are the same, all of you are equally strict, all of you are equally the same. You understand? No, that later on we'll study in ethics, you know, okay, it cannot be that one CA can be replaced by another CA who is like, you know, able to, what you say, able to agree with the views of the client and please the client, right? So that won't, that should not work out, right? So they say, oh God, any CA we go to, same documentation, same strictness, same attitude. Those who are not, all of them, NFRA order coming, है ना? We'll see the NFRA website also later. ठीक है? A glitch in the app till 10, then YouTube link. Ask the team to get it solved for me. Okay. So I'll just pass on your name. You can see the live lecture from tomorrow. Yeah, no problem. That will be taken care of. And I'll just tell it. And my apologies for the inconvenience faced by you. ओके राइट. तो वैसे ना तो थोड़ा मतलब व्हेन नाउ आल्सो एन ऑडिटर इज एंटरिंग इनटू यू ना, वंस यू बिकम अ चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट, यू बिकम एन ऑडिटर. आई वांट यू टू बिकम वेरी डैशिंग, वेरी डायनामिक, वेरी स्किलफुल एंड वेरी व्हाट यू से टैक्टफुल ऑडिटर्स ओवर देयर. एंड यू नीड टू गेट द जिस्ट ऑफ द प्रोफेशन. यू नो यू नीड टू बी द सुपर हीरो और द सुपर, योर थिंकिंग हैज टू बी राइट इन टर्म्स ऑफ डूइंग एन ऑडिट ऑल्सो. एंड फॉर दैट मतलब ये तो थिंकिंग, ये तो स्टाइल ऑफ ऑडिट एंड ऑल ऑफ दैट आई विल टीच यू, बट फॉर दैट टेक्निकली यू हैव टू बी वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग. तो जैसे FR, DT, IDT, मतलब वहां पे एकदम मतलब जो IFRS है, Ind AS का है, कैसे अकाउंटिंग करना है, कैसे दैट हैज टू बी योर स्ट्रेंथ. And that has to be your competency. Only then, if you only don't understand the accounting, how you will check it in audit, right? Not possible now. So for you to check it in audit, you have to be very strong with your fundamentals and your concepts. Okay. Right. So anyways, I was talking about the logo of ICAI, which says here, Esha Supteshu Jagarti, which means that when the world sleeps, we are awake. Right? Or we awaken the world which is just in the slumber or so, right? So we are the awakening, the people who awake everybody in the society or so, right? Because we are vigilant, we are cautious, right? So keeping this motto of ICAI in mind, they have laid down the fundamentals of the code of ethics, right? So first they discuss the term ethics over there. It's the moral principle that governs a person's behavior, right? And then you have the professional ethics, which talks about the personal, organizational, and the corporate standards of behavior expected for the professional. Like as a professional, like as simple as like you are working in a Big Four, say maybe let's take as an example, and you are wearing like like a orange color or some purple color, some shorts, capris over there, and then some t-shirt which has got all the floral print of different colors, and then you're wearing a hat over there, and then you're wearing some colorful goggles over there which has some crooked frame over there, and with that outfit you go to the office or you go to the client place. Like that you go to Goa now, but aise to client ke yahan to you can't go like that now. You can't be going to a client place because that's not professional behavior. That's not at all your professional behavior. That's not how it is expected. Okay, so as simple as that, even that would be counted, that you're going to the client place playing loud music over there. This is not professional behavior. Right? So what you need to have is the behavior expected for the professionals. Okay, right. And obviously, why? Because they are engaged in building the trust. Right, to a vast variety of users, whether it be shareholders, government, investors, which impose a public interest responsibility on their profession. Like, chartered accountant is the fellow who bridges the gap between the board of directors and the shareholders of the company. Right? Because the shareholders, they are the owners of the company, but the owners are not the managers or the runners of the company. They appoint the board of directors who run the company on behalf of the shareholders. So now the shareholders want to know, okay, whatever this board is doing, is it right or wrong? Are they, doing the correct things with our company? So now that is why the shareholders, they appoint the auditors. And then the auditor does the audit and say, shareholder, don't worry, your money is in safe hands. Right? So it's the public interest, right? Since a public interest, like if you want to invest in any IPO, you want to invest in any shares, or you want to do some intraday put option call, karte rehte na aajkal other income, 500 rupees, 300 rupees, you earn something like that over there. Right? So even for that, you study the technicals, right? You study the financials of the company. And so, and obviously, they have to be the audited financial statements. Okay, right. So, code of ethics, right? The credibility of the chartered accountant, the whole foundation of the profession is the credibility, right? And the sole purpose of this, so the main ingredient, and I'm just like they say, the main ingredient in the vegetable is salt. Like how much ever you put the other spices, if salt is not there, no taste. So similarly, chartered accountant ke liye main ingredient is independence. And what they say, independence is non-negotiable. Auditor dekh lo, thoda sa kuch nahi. Independent matlab 100,000% independent. Right? So independence and our institute's motto, that is your Esha Supteshu Jagarti, which means eternal vigilance, right? Awakening when the world is asleep. Right? So public interest and command respect, right? So that's the beginning over there. That gives an introduction regarding why ethics. Then after that, you have the overview of the code of ethics, right? So if you later on today, go through the study material of ICAI also, right? You'll find it that whatever I'm discussing with you over here, right, it is in line with the study material of ICAI, right? So I've put in huge amount of effort and time in preparing, right? So all of this, you see, I've just highlighted the contents and put it at the proper places over there, okay, and eliminated what is repeat or not required as such, okay. Right, so now let's come to our discussion. So right now the focus is on module 2, so just give me a moment. Okay, right, so we have the the overview of the code of ethics, right? So what we have over now, the next discussion over there is regarding the overview of the code of ethics, right? So overview, so you have the entire code of ethics. I can also take you through the ESB website. Just give me a moment over here. If I open the ESBICAI, Ethical Standard Board, ICAI, right? You have the code of ethics which have been issued by the ICAI, right? You have the right the code of ethics. Even though if you see Ethical Standard Board over here, right, the Ethical Standard Board of the ICAI, and they have issued the entire code of ethics over there, right? The entire publications, like if you see the code of ethics 2019 to 2020, right? And then the code of ethics volume 3 is all the case laws, you know, regarding all the orders which have been passed against the chartered accountants wherein they have been guilty of professional or other misconduct under the various, like just as you have your DT ka case laws and IDT ka case laws, like see, these are the case laws for the chartered accountants over there. Right, so under the different clauses when the chartered accountant has been guilty, right? So here they are talking about the overview of the code of ethics, which is yes, so overview of the code of ethics, which has been divided under the four parts. Right, so part one is talking about the conceptual framework, wherein we talk about the fundamental principles. Right, so next I'm going to discuss with you the fundamental principles. What did I tell you? That fundamental principles, we can also refer to it as the ethical requirement. Right? Fundamental principles, we can also refer to fundamental principles as the ethical requirements for a chartered accountant. Right? So you have the fundamental principles, then you have the code of ethics for the professional accountant. So you're the chartered accountant, they refer to him as the professional accountants not in practice. That means the professional accountants in service. Right? That means you're working in the education or not-for-profit sector or as an employee in any organization. Right? So that's the part two of the code of ethics. Right? Then you have the part three of the code of ethics, which is for the professional accountants in the public practice. Right? So those who have taken their COP, right, their certificate of practice from the ICAI, and who are the practicing chartered accountants. Right? So that's the part three of the code of Yes, overview of the code of ethics. And then you have the last one over there, which is the part four, which talks about the independent standards, right? Which talks about the independent standards. And this four is divided under 4A and the 4B, right? 4A is independence for the audit and review, and 4B is independence for other than audit and review. Right, so audit and review, what is the independence requirement when you're appointed to do an audit or a review, and what is the requirement when you're appointed for the other assurance engagement other than the audit or review. Right, so that's just an overview. Maybe somewhere in the MCQ they could ask that part two of the code talks about which of the following, and they can give you the options A, B, C, D over there. Right, so that's the overview of the code of ethics. Right, so part one gives you the fundamental principles. Part two is for the professional accountants in service. Right, so those who are CA, who is an employee, right, who is in job, you know, who is doing a job, right? So that is the part two. So if I'm a CA, I'm practicing also, and I'm also doing a job somewhere, so then it will be applicable to them also. It says chartered accountants who are in public practice but also working as an employee in any company, then to them dono applicable hoga, part 3B, part 2B. If you're only in service, then only part two. If you're only in practice, then only part three. But obviously, if you are in service and in practice, then part two and three both will be applicable. Whether CA in practice can also do a job, that we will see it in the clauses. Right? So clauses, 34 clauses of ethics, we'll see it over there. Okay. Right. And then part three is professional accountants in the public practice. Right, so this is for the practicing chartered accountants, and then you have the part four, which is regarding the independent standards. And I told you the four is divided under the 4A and the 4B, which is for the independence for audit and review, and independence for assurance engagement, which is other than audit and review. Right, so everybody, one page, you know, one by one, ऐसे एक-एक करते सारे pages खत्म हो जाएंगे, है ना? One by one, we'll finish with all the pages which are there in this chapter. Right, so you're understanding what is over here? Right, the overview of the code of ethics. Okay, right. Now picking up the first point over there, which is regarding the fundamental principles, and then also coming to the discussion regarding the independence. Right, so now coming to the first point over there, which is regarding the fundamental principle. Okay, CA, नहीं, दीज आर द फंडामेंटल प्रिंसिपल्स और एथिकल वैल्यूज विच शुड बी देयर इन यू, राइट? व्हाट आर दोज फंडामेंटल प्रिंसिपल्स? फर्स्ट वन, इट सेज चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट, यू शुड बी अ पर्सन ऑफ इंटेग्रिटी, राइट? इंटेग्रिटी, अ पर्सन हु इज वन इन थॉट, वर्ड एंड एक्शन, स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड, ऑनेस्ट एंड सिंसियर, राइट? कैन नॉट बी बेंट, है ना, जस्ट कैन नॉट बी कन्विंस्ड टू वॉट यू वॉन्ट हिम टू से, नहीं होगा, है ना? इंटेग्रिटी, राइट? देन आफ्टर इंटेग्रिटी द नेक्स्ट फंडामेंटल प्रिंसिपल इज द रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्टिविटी. तो ऑब्जेक्टिव मीन्स वॉट? नॉट टू बी सब्जेक्टिव, है ना? बी ऑब्जेक्टिव. यू यू नो, यू योर फ्रेंड आस्क यू हाउ इज दिस ड्रेस एंड यू डोंट लाइक इट, सो यू से आई डोंट लाइक इट. यू डोंट से ओ शी विल फील बैड इफ आई से आई डोंट लाइक इट, सो लेट मी से अरे वाओ इट इज लुकिंग सो नाइस, हाँ फ्रॉम वेयर यू गॉट, कलर इज लुकिंग सो गुड ऑन यू. ऐसे झूठ नहीं बोलने का, यू नो, नॉट टू स्पीक लाइज लाइक दिस. ओके, सो बी ऑब्जेक्टिव. दैट यू से मैम फ्रेंड विल फील बैड, अगेन यू विल से क्लाइंट विल गो समथिंग, फ्रेंड विल गो नाउ यू विल से. तो ठीक है, फ्रेंड पर्सनल लाइफ यू कैन फ्लैटर, यू नो, गिव फॉल्स प्रेजेस ओवर देयर, बट क्लाइंट यू कांट गिव फॉल्स प्रेज ना. अरे कितना मस्त ट्रू एंड फेयर फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स यू प्रिपेयर्ड. नहीं 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 नहीं, नॉट एट ऑल ट्रू एंड फेयर, एब्सोल्यूटली नॉट ट्रू, एब्सोल्यूटली नॉट फेयर. कैन बी, राइट? सो मेंटेन योर ऑब्जेक्टिविटी, राइट? नेक्स्ट एथिकल रिक्वायरमेंट इज द PCDC. ये कौन है PCDC? इट इज द प्रोफेशनल कॉम्पिटेंस एंड द ड्यू केयर, राइट? सो प्रोफेशनली, टेक्निकली एकदम रेजर शार्प यू आर. But you know the provisions of the company law, you know the SEBI provisions, you know the provisions for a telecom company, for a manufacturing industry, for a real estate company. So technically you are sharp and well, what do you say, well accumulated with all the knowledge. Right, and then after that, due care. That means you don't do your work in a haphazard manner, in a inky pinky manner, or you know, in a very unorganized manner. Very, you know, in a very skillful, careful manner, you perform your work. And so that's the professional competence and the due care. Then confidentiality. That means, I think you know this one, right? Confidentiality. Chup baithne ka. Chup. Keep quiet. Not to disclose the secrets of the client. Our client is telling you their secrets for you to do the audit, because you are asking client, what is your future plan? What is your objective? You're trying to understand the entity and its environment. So they are giving you information to facilitate the conduct of the audit. They are not giving you information so that you go and tell everybody when their product is launching and what the price will be and what will be the features and what steps are they taking or who is leaving and who is joining. Nahin. You have to maintain the confidentiality, not to disclose the secrets of the client unless required by law or taken the prior consent of the client, right? And the last ethical requirement over there, or the fundamental principle, is that you need to maintain the professional behavior, right? So professional behavior, right? So avoid any behavior which might bring the disrepute to the profession, which might bring the discredit to the profession, right? So you need to avoid any such behavior, right? So I hope all of you have noted down in your books a heading called as the fundamental principles, and then after that, these are the five fundamental principles. What are those? Integrity, then objectivity, then PCDC, that is professional competence and due care. Then you have to maintain the confidentiality, and you also need to have the professional behavior, right? So integrity, objectivity, PCDC, confidentiality, and the professional behavior. Right, so these are the fundamental principles. Okay, more regarding the fundamental principles and regarding the requirement of independence, we continue with our discussion after the break. Right, so for those of you who are watching me on YouTube also, I will be stopping the streaming now. Then there is another stream which has been created. You need to log in into that stream at say after 10 minutes from now. Right, so just 10 minutes so 10 to 15 minutes break, and then after that we continue with the class, right? And those who are watching on the app, anyways, no problem for you, the lecture will be streamed on the app itself, right? So take a quick break, have some refreshments or so, or any book or something you need to bring it and come back quickly so that we can do our further discussion on the ethics. Okay.